Good morning, students.
This video is in continuation with the previous video wherein we have learned about simple past and past continuous tense. So today we are going to learn about past perfect continuous, and difference between simple past and present perfect tense. Apart from this, we will also see where we can make use of used to. Now, the first thing that we have to see today is past perfect tense. So in past perfect, we make use of had. And along with had, we use past participle, means third form of verb. So in affirmative sentences, our structure will be, she had finished the test. So here, finished is the third form of finish. For negative sentences, we make use of not. So immediately after had, we will use not, and the contracted form of had not is hadn't. Along with that, we will use third form of verb. For example, she hadn't finished the test. So here we are working with third form of finished, and to make negative, we have used hadn't. For interrogative, because in this past perfect, we have a helping verb had. That is why our question will start with the helping verb had. Had plus subject and then third form of verb. For example, had she finished the test? Now, what are the conditions to use them? Past perfect describes an action finished before another past action. So it means when two actions are happening and one action happened before another action, then the action which happened before is represented using past perfect tense. For example, Richard had gone out when his wife arrived in the office. So here two actions are happening. One action is of Richard going out, and another action is of wife arriving in the office. So Richard went out first, and then after that, wife arrived in the office. So this action happened first. That is why it will be in past perfect. And another action of wife arriving in the office happened later. That is why it is in simple past. It is also used with such words like hope, expect, think, suppose, etc. when it isn't realized. Realized means when those conditions are not fulfilled or completed. So for example, I had hoped that I would pass. It means I hoped to get passed, but I couldn't. So any hope or desire or wish which you want to happen, but it didn't happen. So in that case also, we make use of past perfect tense. Then past perfect continuous, as we have seen in present perfect continuous also, that it is combination of perfect and continuous both. So similarly in past perfect continuous also, we will make use of past perfect, that is had. We will also make use of past continuous, that is ing form of verb. And in order to make it past perfect continuous, we have to connect both of them with the help of been, right? So past perfect continuous tense accepts had, ing form of verb, and along with that, been. So in affirmative sentences, the sentence will be, they had been playing tennis. This been will be used before between the helping verb and the main verb. For negative, we will add not after had, and then between this helping verb and the main verb, we will make use of been. So the sentence will be, they hadn't been playing tennis. And as we have this helping verb had in the sentence, so our question in interrogative will start with had, then subject, and then been. So here been will be used after the subject, and after that ing form of the verb. So had they been playing tennis? So please remember, this been will always be used between the helping verb and the main verb. It cannot be used after the main verb, or it cannot be used before the helping verb. Now the conditions to use perfect continuous tense. First is to describe a past action that has already started and continued up to another action or time in the past. So again, here we are talking about two actions. But in past perfect, we talked that one action had already completed when another action started. But here, first action was in continuation when another action started. So the first action hasn't completed, right? So this is past perfect continuous. When the first action was still going on by the time the second action started. For example, the boys had been playing soccer for about an hour when it started to rain. So it means it started raining. Until that time, boys were playing soccer. Right? So it means they had not stopped playing soccer before it started to rain. They were still playing when it started raining. It is also used to express an action that has just finished. An action that was in continuation and got over just now. For example, Shuchi had been talking to her friends, right? So it means that she was in continuation. She was talking and just before some moment, she stopped talking to her friends. Now, most of the time we get confused that where to use simple past and where to use present perfect, right? Because present perfect also talks about the action which have been completed, but just before some time, right? So where to use simple past and where to use present perfect? We use simple past for the actions that happened in the past and is over, done or finished. So any action that started in the past and now it is over or it is finished. It is no more in continuation. So there we make use of simple past. We use present perfect for the action that started in the past but is still true today. So the action might have started in the past but it has its effect in the present also. There we make use of present perfect tense. Let's have an example. I lived in Korea for 2 years. Now see, my action started in the past, right? And it continued till 2 years and it got over before the present time. So it means it has no effect in present. So that is why it is represented in simple past. This lived is second form of verb. It means it is in simple past. So this sentence means I lived in Korea for 2 years, but don't live in Korea now. Now I no more live in Korea. Whereas if we say I have lived in Korea for 2 years, it means what? Have lived. Have lived means present perfect. It means what? That still I am living in Korea. I started living in Korea 2 years back. So means action has started in the past, but it has its effect in the present also. So that is why I'm using present perfect. So it means that I started living in Korea 2 years ago and still live there now. So my action has its effect in the present also. Now the last thing is to understand the use of used to. Used to denotes something that happened in the past but does not happen now. Anything which you used to do in the past but you don't follow it nowadays, that is represented using used to. For example, Rama used to ride a scooty when she was in college. So she no more rides a scooty now. She used to do it when she was in college. I used to enjoy pop music when I was in school. So I no more enjoy pop music now. I used to enjoy it when I was in school. So this is something which I used to do earlier, but I don't do it nowadays. So this is all for today. We will meet again in the next video with future tense. So till that time, go through the topics again and for better understanding of this concept.